Thank you to MonkPack for sponsoring today's episode. MonkPack offers low-sugar bars, which are plant-based, gluten-free, and keto-friendly. Click the link in the description and you will receive 20% off your first purchase of any MonkPack product. About 2.5 million years ago, a nearby star went supernova, and it was so close to Earth that it would have been visible during the day. After that explosion, a shower of cosmic particles rained down on us. Scientists think this particle bombardment might have shaped how planet Earth looks today, and they were able to track those effects not by looking up to space, but down to the bottom of the sea. Although a wave of cosmic rays crashed onto Earth millions of years ago, they did not come directly from the supernova itself. Instead, when the star blew up, it created a shockwave that pushed neighboring atoms like hydrogen and helium until they eventually got to Earth, where they rained down for thousands of years as cosmic rays. And this constant onslaught had consequences for our planet. Cosmic rays could have kickstarted chemical reactions in our atmosphere, forming compounds that contain nitrogen. And many plants use these types of compounds as fertilizers. So when they eventually got to Earth's soil, they could have facilitated the growth of plants. One other thing plants use for growth is carbon dioxide, a key ingredient for photosynthesis. If enough carbon dioxide was consumed by these plants, they could have helped cool down the planet. That means that it is possible that a supernova, hundreds of light years away from Earth, could have helped trigger a massive climate change. But it is tricky to know all of this happened for sure, because the event took place way before human records. Like, way before! Luckily, scientists were able to track some clues. See, when the star exploded, it left some evidence on our planet. Radioactive atoms hidden in the bottom of the sea. Now, there are a lot of radioactive atoms in space, especially in stars, which have enough energy to form them. And when these stars explode, some of that debris takes part in the formation of planets like Earth. So chemically, our planet is made of similar atoms to those found on stars. Which is a pain in the butt for some scientists, because when they try to differentiate, like, new star stuff from the stuff that makes up Earth, they run into a pickle, because those two things are very similar. However, a key property of these radioactive particles is that they decay over time because they are unstable. That's what makes them radioactive. So they keep releasing radiation until they become non-radioactive. And some of those particles have been on Earth for a really long time, which means that they are no longer radioactive. So if scientists find million-year-old space particles that are still radioactive, that means that they were not from our planet's formation, so they must have come from another place or event, like the explosion of a supernova. In essence, scientists were looking for a needle in a haystack, and against all odds, they found it. Radioactive particle that fit the bill was iron-60. Iron-60 is a radioactive isotope of iron, and the 60 in its name comes from the 4 extra neutrons it has compared to the most common isotope of iron, iron-56. That makes iron-60 radioactive. This isotope has a half-life of around 2.6 million years. So after that amount of time passes, only half of the original iron-60 should still be around. The problem is finding iron-60. Remember, we're talking about atoms that came from space more than 2 million years ago. To measure iron-60, you first need to find a sample that has survived for millions of years with enough iron-60 left to detect. And after a very extensive search, researchers found that perfect sample at the bottom of the ocean. More specifically, in a section of the ocean where sediment doesn't settle, like on the slopes of seamounts or in places with a strong current. In those places, the ocean floor is dominated by something called ferromanganese crusts, which is where metal particles shift from being dissolved in seawater to their concentrated solid form. And they do that very slowly. We're talking about a few millimeters of accumulation every million years. After analyzing samples from those crusts, scientists found traces of iron-60, one of the radioactive isotopes from the supernova. The first study on this from 1999 proved that we could at least detect supernova remnants here on Earth. And scientists have not stopped there. Since then, they have also found traces of star stuff in fossils, because all animals take iron into their bodies from their diet. By looking at where all of those radioactive elements ended up in the world, scientists could determine how far away the supernova was by modeling the trajectory that that material took to make it to Earth. They concluded that it happened about 150 to 300 light years away, leading them to their next question. Could we see a supernova event like this again? Well, according to astronomers, yes And no, it would have to happen pretty close to our planet for a supernova to affect us anywhere between 30 to 300 light years. But that said, supernovas are fairly common. The universe is an unimaginably big place. Even in our Milky Way galaxy, supernovas happen a few times a century. So it's not unthinkable that another supernova could happen close enough to Earth to be noticeable. If another supernova happened that close, we wouldn't get hit directly by X-rays and gamma rays because we'd be far enough away, but it would definitely be visible from Earth, and those accelerated cosmic rays would still pepper our atmosphere for decades. We are still learning about the effects the last nearby supernova had on the planet, so it's hard to predict exactly what future effects could be. Climate change and an increase in radiation exposure could all be within the realm of possibility. But there's no reason to panic. There aren't any stars likely to go supernova in our immediate celestial neighborhood. The closest supernova candidate, Betelgeuse, is more than 500 light years away. And the math is on our side, because other likely candidates are moving farther away from us, not closer. So chances are, we won't see an event like the one our ancestors witnessed millions of years ago anytime soon. But although we will not see one like that old supernova, its remnants will still be a part of us. But something you hopefully have seen today is your breakfast. But if you had to skip it because you were in a rush, no worries, today's sponsor Monk Pack can lend you a hand next time. They have a wide selection of granola and nut and seed bars, so if you need a quick, nutritious meal or a snack between meetings, you can check their options, which are all low-sugar, plant-based, and gluten-free. To give them a try, click the link in the description or visit monkpack.com to get 20% off your first purchase after you enter the promo code SciShow. And your purchase is backed with a 100% happiness guarantee, so if you don't like it for any reason, Monk Pack will exchange the product or refund your money, whichever you prefer.